Listen to the story Grandma Surprise by Rachna Chhabria. Sean got down from his school bus and started walking towards his house. It was Saturday, a half day at school. He didn't look forward to returning home as both his parents would be at work. Things had been going badly for him ever since his grandmother had come to stay with them 2 months ago. No birthday party because Grandma fell ill. No pets allowed because Grandma was allergic to fur. No music and no lights after 9:30 because Grandma needed rest. His mother had even stopped preparing his favorite dishes. She cooked only what his grandmother liked to eat. How unfair! Sean hardly spoke to his grandmother. Even his cousins had told him she was a grouchy woman. Sean rang the doorbell. He heard his grandmother's footsteps as she walked down the passage towards the door. The moment she opened the door, he rushed into his room and flung himself and his school bag on the bed. The bag burst open and a few books fell out of the bag onto the floor. A little while later, Grandma entered the room. She picked up the books and put them back into the bag. Sean pretended to be asleep. As soon as she left the room, he sat up in bed. Then he lay down again. 15 minutes later, a delicious aroma spread through the house. Sean's stomach growled. But he didn't leave the room. He just lay in bed with his eyes closed. Suddenly, he heard his grandmother enter the room. "You must be hungry. Let's eat," she said. Holding his hand, she dragged him to the dining room. Sean's eyes widened. Grandma had cooked his favorite dishes. Fried rice, noodles, and spicy vegetable stew. The food was yummy, better than what his mother cooked. They ate in silence. "It's yummy," Sean said, taking second helpings of everything. "Would you like me to help you with your Hindi lessons?" his grandmother asked him suddenly. How do you know?" Sean stammered. "The test paper fell out of your bag," she said softly. Sean stared at his grandmother. There was a look of genuine concern in her eyes. Grandma was nothing like what his cousins had told him. Even though she hadn't been feeling well, she had cooked for him. "Dad will get angry when he sees my marks," he said, lowering his head. "Don't worry, I'll talk to him." His grandmother smiled. Patting his back, she said, "Finish your lunch and don't worry. I'll take care of it." In the evening, when his father returned from office, Sean saw Dad and Grandma talking softly, expecting a scolding from his father. Sean was surprised when his dad let him off with a gentle warning. "Ma has assured me that your Hindi marks will improve. Don't trouble her. Study hard," his father said. Sean returned to his room. He found a gift-wrapped package on his bed. "Your belated birthday present." Grandmother's eyes twinkled. Sean eagerly tore open the wrapping. It was a laptop. Hugging his grandmother tightly, Sean said, "Thanks, Grandma. You are the best. You are my grandma, my tuition teacher, and my new friend."